Good afternoon. I'm Francisco Ponce, neurosurgeon at Barrow Neurological Institute, and welcome to our second live feed of deep brain stimulation. So we're going to be doing deep brain stimulation today, a patient with Parkinson's disease, we're going to be stimulating the globus pallidus interna, the GPI. So we're ready to roll right here. So just to kind of orient you to the room, we have a CT scanner right here. This is the intraoperative CT scanner. And we're about to register this fiducial box, the stereotactic frame. This is a Lexell stereotactic frame, and this is something we've pinned onto the patient's head. And this is going to be the tool we use to obtain a set of coordinates that corresponds to a surgical plan that I have on the MRIs that we obtained preoperatively. So I'm going to be walking through that shortly. But as we kind of start moving along with the operation, basically this is the little box with little markers in it that our software that I'll be walking you through shortly will pick up. And using these markers, we translate a three-dimensional plan on MRI to real space. So we're going to go ahead and get the scan right now, and we can keep feeding as we get the CT scanner in. So this is a patient with Parkinson's disease. And Parkinson's, the cardinal features of Parkinson's disease include stiffness, bradykinesia, slowness. Stiffness is rigidity, and tremor. So tremor, bradykinesia, and rigidity are the three cardinal features. He actually has a pretty significant dystonia, which is like painful cramping, which he first noticed in his legs and also affects his left upper extremity. So left upper and lower extremities are affected by dystonia. And for that, he's been undergoing Botox. So that, in addition to classic Parkinson's and taking medications four times a day, have been reasons why he's been referred for deep brain stimulation. Currently, we treat about 180 new patients a year at Barrow with deep brain stimulation for Parkinson's. And we have many more patients now undergoing deep brain stimulation for essential tremor and for epilepsy. But Parkinson's disease remains the most common indication. So what we're doing right now is we're centering the patient in the CT scanner to obtain the three-dimensional images. And with those, we'll get the set of coordinates to plan our operation. This operation typically takes about an hour to an hour and a half to perform, and then he'll be back a couple weeks from now to get the internal pulse generator implanted. That's the battery that goes into the chest. And then once the device is activated, we anticipate improvements with those features of Parkinson's, the tremor, the stiffness, the slowness, as well as his dystonia and any dyskinesias that he gets as a side effect of medication. I'll show it right here. So in circumstances like this, we're better off rotating the bed that way than raising the bed.
Okay.
So.
Can we rotate the bed?
Yeah. Just ask us. Yeah.
Okay.
Let me know when it's good. Is that good right there?
Yeah.
Okay. So the lower the head is, the closer it is to the isocenter, and
yeah.
That's better.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah.
So we probably don't want that being
broadcasted. Right, okay.